Come
hey,
you stand no me. Chance against us.
Never you.
Shall you face off against still waters? Shall you? Shall you?
I challenge you to a duel.
Noble lords and virtuous ladies, another fight is soon to begin. And gentlemen, the Witcher defeats the previously invincible Stillwaters, and what about it was? Freed of his vow, the knight can now show his face.
Your blows are strong and true. My congratulations.
Thanks.
Have you naught to add? I'm a woman. No wry remarks?
What for? It's the 13th century. Nothing peculiar about it. Women own taverns, run farms, and fight.
Will you not claim there was no honor in fighting a wench?
No. I'd expect to hear that from someone who was afraid to lose to a woman.
Now only Colossus stands between you and a chance at the maestro. San Sebastian, that's where you should go. Look for the largest courtyard.
Come here!
Run, Roach. Let's go.
Slow and steady winds the race.
Hey, Master Witcher, will you face Colossus? Look to be a man in search of exertion. Hey, Whitelocks, will you dare to fight Colossus?
Fine, let's fight.
Ah, boring. I'm not interested. Quick I am, too quick for you. It'll be knick-knack, patty-whack. Here's your arm ball. Where's the sport in it?
Don't want to fight? Why bother looking for challengers then? Wasting my time.
Whoa, a bit testy are we. A Witcher, right? Let's do it like this. You parry three blows I throw your way, you win. But you can't swing at me, not once. Just deflect my blows, got it? Catch three of them, and I'll toss you double your wager.
Feeling that generous?
No, I just know you can't do it. No one's ever done it. Too fast, see? So, willing to try for three blocks?
Fine. Doubt I'll have any trouble deflecting a few blows.
That I get. At long last, one with a sportsman's soul. Now, listen. The rules say you're not to start your parry until I've cocked my fist. Standing with your guard ups, not allowed.
Ladies and gentlemen, witness a most peculiar fight. How shall I say this? The Witcher has accepted a colossal challenge. Incredible! The Witcher has parried Colossus's blows. No one's ever managed that feat.
Here's your due.
Thanks.
You've earned my esteem, sir. We've not seen such a feat in years, and thus you've secured the right to challenge the Maestro himself. You'll find him by the docks.
Had enough. All of it.
Fuck.
Aid a miserable portal.
Giddy up.
Life invoked now can be quite dear. Death, though, that's always free. The advice, Witcher. If you've no reason to live, lift us.
That move.
Dive! We safe and fast!
That white sword. Jump, they say he's no slap.
This where I find the boxer they call the Maestro?
Maestro, champ, the undefeated. Folk call him many things. You are the Witcher who dropped the three lesser champions?
I am. Come to fight the Maestro, but seems to me he's indisposed.
Alcohol is the Maestro's remedy for his crippling shyness. He's a delicate man, you see? He'd never so much as hit a pillow while sober.
Fighting sober's like dancing to silence.
Let's go. I challenge you.
Hold on. Whoa. I'm a man of principle. I keep to a code. I don't tinkle where I eat, and I don't fight folk who don't drink.
Meaning
you're to drink, or hey, diddle diddle out of here.
Sheesh, fine.
Mesdames, messieurs, the Maestro will perform at last.
Let's do this.
When I chop you, bum!
Pathetic.
Hey, well parried that. Under it cost, yes. When I shot, you little bumble! Hey, well past that. And a riposte, yes. Ah, scum. You beat me. It's not happened in years. Your fists, they're glorious.
Thanks.
I'm gobsmacked, I am. I have to drink it off. Oof, good fight. To speak true, I'm pleased you stripped me of the title. I shall have more time to pursue my chief interest now.
Witcher Geralt of Rivia is hereby crowned Fisticuffs Champion of Beauclair. Bravo! Behold your trophy.
A life without liquor's like loving without licking.
Show me your sword.
Come on.
If in a horse drops if you ride it, the coast of gallop.
Water, just like...
Like who?
Like a pond skater. Who are you thinking?
No matter. I suppose you thought nothing else in life could surprise you, eh? Wrong.
Hey, happen to know how the hell I can walk on that water?
Naturally, I know. Since time immemorial have I dwelt in solitude on this shore, and I can testify to the extraordinary nature of the lake.
What's so extraordinary about it? I mean, besides the fact that you can walk on its surface.
A sword, most wondrous, lies in its depths. I watch over it. The blade may be grasped solely by one who possesses the five chivalric virtues.
Folk call me a lot of things, but virtuous? I don't know.
Yet I do know, for I know who you are. You have proven yourself capable of great sympathy. You are a man of honor, as many can attest. Of humble means yourself, you show generosity to others. Your valor is the stuff of legends. reason guides your actions, as it does those of all who are wise. You have proven the five chivalric virtues dwell in your heart.
Mean the sword's mine? I can dive in and take it?
The sword deserves the hand of a master. You must prove your skills are worthy through combat atop the water's surface. Are you ready?
Anytime.
Then draw your blade.
This is the last.
Have proven worthy of wielding the blade, beyond all doubt.
Behold. Your Arendite.
We've met before.
Certainly. The hermit admitted he knew you, remember?
The Lady of the Lake.
It is I. Forget not that you are a man right and honorable, devoted to doing good. And for these reasons you received the blade. Now bear it. And I trust this time you shall not lose it.
Just wonderful.
Come on.
Rolling on an empty stomach. Oof.
All is in order.
no fuss! Water, no wine!
Come on now.
And kids.
Sir, come to me, please. Approach. My eyes were not deceived. Yet so far south. You, sir, of all folk in all your fame.
Mm-hmm. Me, south in all my fame.
Ach, I've heard so much. Why, when Master Dandelion tarried in Beauclair, not a day passed without him baying out a ballad in admiration of your deeds.
Yeah, unwelcome little habit of his. But what can I do for you?
Ah, you see, my betrothed, Francois Le Goff, vowed in my honor to bring me the head of the horrid beast they call Gwetore.
Couldn't have gotten you a bouquet, some sweets and a bag?
Witcher, sir, you jest. A love most true demands proof through heroic deeds dedicated to the heart's captor. But alas, Francois has been gone a fortnight. Thus, I must plead with you to see what's become of him. Could you? Would you?
Do my damnedest to get your fiancé back safe and sound. Just, mind telling me where to look for him?
I forget you come from afar and do not know our land. They say Gwetore has its lair in the caves at the foot of the Gorgon Hills.
That close to the city? Telling me no bold souls have ventured out to defeat the beast?
Quite the contrary. Plenty have, but none's returned. My concern is well founded.
I see. All right. High time I set off.
Come on, Roach.
When the clock strikes six,
Gideon.
Ladies start to work their lips.
The fragrant whiff. What is the pheasantry stewing up?
Inscriptions in Elder Speech. Salvation lies not
in our journal, long gone in our hearts.
Guess somebody else will know about it too. Should look around, see if I can find something else. Footprints, narrow and shallow. Somebody small, light. Woman, maybe? Wonder where they lead. Professor certainly can't do much to help me with my search. Damn it, trail breaks off. Wonder if the grave robber learned more than I did. Won't learn anything else here.
map Triss sent me will have to do. Also, Epitaph mentioned both Elrin and Dolnevda, Valley of the Nine. Site marked on the map's all wet now. Saint Retour flows through there. Must be where the Valley of the Nine once lay. Need to explore the location.
Run, Roach! Let's go! Come on, Roach.
Regis. Couldn't have picked some other place to meet. grave robber must have found something in Moreau's tomb to activate the entry portal. Wonder what surprises this place has in store. Implanted spikes. Sick sense of humor someone's got. Soaked. Grave robber was wounded while attempting the climb. Needed to bandage up. Managed to avoid the panthers at least. Four protruding stones. Gotta press them somehow. Crossbow, maybe? Could try to hit them. Something like that myself.
did it.
Interesting as places go. Seems someone put a lot of thought into its design. Should look around. Impressive. It's just decoration, or... his lab. Intriguing as machinery goes, but how do I start it up? Guessing this man didn't come here willingly. Just need to pick an entry.
The 18th of Yule, year 1102. Today I begin my great life's endeavor. one greater and more significant than any I have thus far undertaken. For it relates to me personally, to myself and my son. When 15 years passed, a beast of the forest assaulted me. A witcher came to my aid, saved my life. I could not know that for said salvation, I would in the end pay by relinquishing any say as to my own son's fate. Had I the skill to turn back time, I would have done so, and perished rather than surrender to the witcher as my only son. But as it was, on the day when Jerome was taken, I swore an oath on my honor that I would recover my son. Today, following years of research and preparation, I have at last devised a device that allows me to study mutations. If the gods in their goodness grant me but a bit of favor, I shall find a way to reverse said mutations and restore Jerome to a normal life.
So, Professor wasn't out to enhance Witcher mutations, wanted to reverse them. Wonder if he managed, and if there's anything in it for me.
Observation 22. Despite applying a surfeit of toxic substances, significantly more than usual, the subject displayed no symptoms of overdosing. I believe this to be an effect of the mutations. Thus, a minor success. This mutation should allow Jerome better to tolerate toxicity. Observation number 30. The mutations do not set in at once. Curiously, they do not develop over a span of time. Rather, for a mutation to progress towards completion, the appropriate mutagen must be applied continuously. The subject does not bear this well, but I found a way to make the mutations less taxing, invasive. To the mutagen base, I add the albumin of a mutated giant centipede egg. Stored in a glass terrarium, the eggs do not develop. Remain small. The eggs themselves are a sight to behold. Mutated, they are luminescent, emitting a wondrous glow. I can only hope my addition of the albumin will produce no significant side effects. Time will tell.
Crystal for this entry's missing. Might be somewhere. Should look around.
Years of experiments. Research. Sacrifice. All for naught. I have failed to achieve my defined objective. Each mutation I applied to my subjects proved ineffective when applied to Jerome. What I meant to cure him of his witcherism, that which I meant to restore to him a normal life, only deepened his mutations, further augmented his speed and strength, rendered him yet more inhuman. It seems my son must remain a witcher forever. I have failed. The time has come to abandon this place. Return home to Lydia. She may yet deign to take me back. The contraption and mutagens I leave here, let them wither and crumble, as did my dreams of regaining my son.
So the professor wanted to reverse the mutation's effects. Ended up deepening them. Stroke of luck for me. Could profit from his failure. So, Professor tried to neutralize the effects of Witcher mutations. Only managed to enhance them, though. Used the albumins of giant centipede eggs as his mutagen base. Need to go on an egg hunt. Crystals. Should mount them in the megascope. Missing one last crystal. Quite the library. Mostly tomes on mutations and genetics. Preserved organs. Hope their donors weren't forced to give them up. This crystal must go here. All crystals in place. Show me what you got. Just need to pick an entry.
Observation 58. Sometimes failure is the catalyst for success. I've discovered a method by which one type of mutagen may be transmuted into another through the addition of certain ingredients. This is a great day for science.
In addition, I observed that today's dose of mutagens brought the subject to the brink of death. He then suddenly awoke, revived, his strength renewed. Not wholly, of course, but he did, in a sense, come back from the edge of death. Whether this is attributable to his mutations or to pure coincidence cannot be ascertained. I must conduct further experiments.
Seen enough. Just need to pick an entry. Seen enough. No point going in wearing full gear. Gotta drop my armor, leave my weapons. Professor's mutagens might work on me as they did on his son. Well, time to find out. Cell for portals. Feels dead. Maybe a sign will revive it.
bear the scars of that witch's visit.